Oh, boy, that was fun. Piece of advice, Mac. Never see a movie when you can't pronounce the title. There's 2 hours of my life I'm never getting back.
Well, you can afford to.
What exactly is the attraction here, Mac? Is it the overacting with bad subtitles?
It's supposed to be enlightening.
Boring is my boss.
You mean no great lines, no, nothing like, hasta la vista, baby,
exactly.
Or, I'll be back.
That's it.
Ready to roll, Mr. Petrovic.
You mean no fight scenes to hold the story together?
That's precisely what I'm talking about.
You know
about.
What? You're a worry.
Excuse me.
Are you okay?
Yeah. Come on, Mac, he's getting away.
I think so. Oh, I'm all right, I'm all right. He saved my life.
Good, David. Good. I'm glad.
Alice?
No. No. No.
That is the question.
Does the boy do your fighting for you?
What are you doing, Mac?
Don't worry, old friend.
He is Duncan MacLeod, the Highlander. Born in 1592 in the Highlands of Scotland, and he is still alive. He is immortal. For 400 years, he's been a warrior, a lover, a wanderer, constantly facing other immortals in combat to the death. The winner takes his enemy's head, and with it, his power. I am a watcher, part of a secret society of men and women who observe and record, but never interfere. We know the truth about immortals. In the end, there can be only one. May it be Duncan MacLeod, the Highlander.
Here we are, born to be kings. We're the princes of the universe. I am immortal. I have inside me blood of kings. I have no rival. No man can be my equal. Take me to the future.
Hey, Rich, what's up?
Last night, the guy we saved?
Yeah, what about him?
Name's David Mark. One of the bullets that went through the window killed his wife.
What?
Check it out. The police are looking for us. They want us to identify the killer.
We can't.
Excuse me?
We weren't there.
Then I must have one hell of an imagination.
Rich, we can't afford the publicity this sort of thing brings.
What's the worst thing that could happen?
Kimmon.
What about him?
But he doesn't know who you are. I want to keep it that way.
He's that good, huh?
That good.
Oh. I swear that wicket is smaller than the rest. No other, just that one.
Perhaps the wicket is of regulation width, but it is your ball that is larger than the rest.
You would do well to refrain from commenting on the play.
To be truthful, by and large, the game is not at the forefront of my thoughts, Your Majesty.
I'm sure you'll tell us what is.
The mounting tensions between England and Scotland. My friend Duncan MacLeod speaks for the clans.
Are you concerned about the war, Duncan MacLeod?
I would think the war is of grave concern to us all, Your Majesty.
I believe it's your turn.
To be perfectly candid, there are thousands of loyal Scots that have died on French soil fighting for you, my queen.
Indeed, while your nobles tax them into oblivion. Mark my words, there will be a civil war with Scotland because of it.
Such talk borders on treason, sir. How dare you?
Lord Wellesley, we will decide what is treasonous in our presence and what is not.
Of course, Your Majesty.
Lord Dennis, there is a time to discuss our war with the French and a time to keep your mind on the game and your thoughts to yourself.
I think we have made our point.
Nonsense. The Queen respects a strong will. Duncan feels I should hold my tongue.
We are inclined to agree.
I, on the other hand, feel that right is right, and I don't care a whit who hears my opinions on the matter.
Then you are a fool. And we don't care to associate with fools.
Red, I thought you were in trouble then. Oh, but Dennis, when you talked about the war...
Duncan, I don't care what they think.
I may not be a diplomat, but I do know about timing, and yours is terrible.
Maybe the Queen has time to spare, but England doesn't.
The Queen can be our greatest ally. You said so yourself when we met in the Highlands months ago. Now that I've seen it, I know it to be true.
All of these men have lost friends and family in this accursed war.
Aye, but can you not use your head instead of your heart?
I spoke the truth.
I have no quarrel with what you say. It's how and when you see it.
Barkeep. Ale. Do you have any that's fit to drink?
What brings you here, sir?
Why, the same as you, sir. I have a thirst. Although by the looks of things, your thirst is not for drink, but for the commoner's adulation.
These are my friends.
And no different than you.
Indeed, they are not, sir.
How many of your friends play croquet for a living?
Gentlemen, why don't we have a drink and discuss the affairs of the day in good cheer?
Are you insulting me? Your politics do that well enough.
Let us return to our ales.
If you're not careful, that drink will be your last. You affix yourself to royalty, like a louse affixes itself to a horse's ass. And yet you say your loyalties lie with these people. How disingenuous of you. Oh! How common! Was that your way of challenging me?
Tomorrow, at noon,
I shall look forward to it.
Dennis, let us not bother with this nonsense. We have more important matters to discuss.
What are you saying?
Do you not see he was goading you into a challenge? Withdraw it and forget him.
Withdraw? The man is a fop. I'll dispatch him tomorrow and be done with it.
He is more than he seems.
There's nothing more to discuss.
Let me take the challenge.
The insult was to me.
Damn it, man, you are a fool. The Queen was right. Your Grace. Kinman, I should like to speak with you.
You may speak.
I'm not asking your permission. I will speak with you. But privately.
I'm currently entertaining. Perhaps another time.
There will be no other time.
Very well. If it's the only way to have any peace. Yes, yes.
I have come here to ask you not to fight my friend tomorrow.
Certainly. Have him apologize publicly, then shut his mouth forever about his bloody politics, and the matter will be closed.
It is an unfair fight, and you know it.
It is a matter of honor.
There is no honor in fighting a man when the advantage is yours. It is sport and nothing more.
I never fight for sport.
Then let the duel be to first blood. Honor will be satisfied, and the matter will be closed.
What concern is it of yours? He's not one of us.
Do we agree?
Oh, very well, my dear fellow, very well.
Do a good job of it tomorrow, Paul. Dennis is entirely too friendly with the Scots. He needs to be taught a lesson.
Trust me, Your Grace. The matter is in good hands.
It seems your confidence is sufficiently boasted.
First blood has been drawn. The duel is over. Honor has been satisfied. You proved your courage.
I nearly broke a sweat there. Is there anyone else at home who could provide me with more distraction? A sister, perhaps?
Sir, you will take back those words or I'll have your head. That would be quite a show, wouldn't it?
Let it stand.
And after I've had your sister, perhaps your mother would care to be entertained.
My you.
Oh. You're next.
Duncan MacLeod?
Yeah, can I help you?
Jill Brooks, FBI. Glad I found you.
Sure. What's this about?
Testifying against Paul Kinman.
Sorry, who?
The man who killed Alice Markham last night.
Oh, the woman in the newspaper? Well, what would I have to do with that?
We weren't at the Geyser Theater on Sierra Road around 11 p.m.?
No, sorry.
Don't look at me.
And you didn't get between David Markham and the bullet?
I think you've got me mixed up with somebody else.
Well, I got a witness says you saw two guys with a T-bird chase a shooter. You know, one was tall, long hair, well-built. The other was about 20, short hair, blue T-shirt. Now, I've been tracking T-birds all day long. Now I'm standing here with you and your friend. Well, I see I found my boys.
There must be a lot of guys who look like us.
You're right. Look, cops caught the guy in a parking garage around the corner. Guy's a pro, very smart. Bureau's been tracking him for about 5 years. Never had enough for an arrest.
86 3/8, Richie. Well, I guess congratulations are in order.
Not yet, they're not. The guy ditched the weapon and the mask before the police got to him. Now, the only ones who can tie him into the shooting are the guys who chased him.
Well, good luck finding them.
No, I already found them. You were there. You saw the guy. You can put him away. Are you going to testify?
Sorry, wish I could help.
Okay. You don't want to talk to me? That's fine. You can talk to the local cops. Because if I found you, so will they.
Am I missing something here, Mac? If Kinman is such a badass, why don't we just testify and put him away so he can't hurt anybody?
Richie, I don't want to put him away. I want to bury him.
Days. You must ask me the same questions 50 times.
And you told them?
Just like we talked about. We're training at the dojo. I still don't think they believe me.
My guess is he's got a lawyer by now. They can hold him for 48 hours without charging him.
And then you're going to be waiting for him when he gets out.
That's right.
What if he wins?
Then you better take the first bus out of town.
Come out!
It is you.
I'm sorry about your wife, Mr. Markham.
How sorry are you? They told me inside you weren't going to testify. They said you told them you weren't even there.
There's nothing I can do.
You can tell them the truth, damn it!
You'll have your justice. Trust me, it's better this way.
Better for who? I mean, what? Are you afraid? Or did he buy you? Whatever it is, I'll match it.
Go home, Mr. Markham.
You son of a bitch, you can't let him walk! Go!
I said go home.
You're going to let him get away with killing my wife? You're nothing but a damn coward.
Why don't you just relax? Remember, this guy saved your life.
It's okay, Richie. Forget it.
Coward. Coward!
See the anger in your eyes. I too was loath to hear of Dennis's death.
It will not go unanswered.
I understand your hatred of Kinman's act, but it was not one of his own making. He was paid to kill Dennis by those who wished to see the war with France continue.
Whether paid or not, he will be dealt with.
Court is alive with treachery. Jacobites, Tories, Whigs, French spies all at each other's throats. This intrigue serves no one.
Your Majesty, may I come closer?
You may take your leave.
Yes, Your Majesty.
I care not about treachery or intrigue. I care about justice. I only want Kinman.
My people are divided. I will not give them a battle between a Catholic Scotsman and a Protestant Englishman. That will divide them further.
But you cannot ask me to do nothing.
I can ask what I will. I am your queen. And I will have your word that you will not fight Kinman.
I beg you, Your Majesty. It would be better to ask for my life than to ask for this.
There is more at stake here than your pride. I have a nation to protect. I will have your word. And I will have it now.
I swear. As long as the Queen reigns, I will not fight him. A good friend. Right. And a good man.
Aye.
Lord Dennis Keating.
Lord Dennis Keating.
He was the only one in the chamber who was decent.
Barkeep. Two ales. Your pints.
Does it always smell like this in here?
Mm. Ah, Duncan MacLeod, my very good friend. I didn't see you back here. Perhaps you can help us.
I have nothing to say to you.
Nonsense. All you need to do is settle a little argument between my very good friend, the Earl of Wellesley, and myself. You see, the Earl thinks young Dennis died like a man. I, on the other hand, think he died like a stuck pig. What do you think?
Another one.
It is kind.
Well, apparently we're here to learn our lesson.
Mm. And what lesson is that?
A coward who holds his tongue will live to quiver another day. Yes. Is there something you wanted to say? It walks like a man. It talks like a man.
But it slithers out on its belly.
It's a challenge.
You coward.
Coward.
Coward!
Coward!
Coward. Stay out there.
Coward.
Good.
Coward! Coward!
Coward!
Testify. You have to make them testify.
Well, if they both hold their stories, there's nothing we can do.
You could arrest them.
On what charge?
Please, you have to do something. There has to be justice.
I promise you, Mr. Markham, Kinman is not going to walk away from this thing. Now give me your gun.
I keep it in the store for protection.
Give it to me. Please. Come on. You might as well talk to me, Kinman, because your ass is nailed.
What shall we talk about, Agent Brooks? The war in Bosnia? How the Yankees did last week?
Let's talk about the murder you committed last night. If you want to talk about something else, let's talk about Michael Taussig in Chicago.
Daniel Rothstein in Philly. Perry Tavlin in Miami.
Are these people I'm supposed to know?
They're people you killed.
Really? You'd think I'd remember something like that.
You're going away this time, Kinman. I got two witnesses that ID'd you.
I don't think so. If you did have somebody willing to talk, I'd be in front of a judge right now being arraigned, not sitting here talking to you. Watch this. Nothing up my sleeve. Look what's in my hand. Why, it's nothing. And that's exactly what you have, Agent Brooks. Nothing.
Well, you're wrong. See, I got this. Now, what do you have to say?
Kayla, what the hell are you doing?
My job, cleaning up the streets.
Frank, don't let her do this.
I'm gonna kill you now, you bastard. How does it feel?
Kayla, don't. He's not worth it.
If we don't charge him, he'll walk. I'm not gonna let that happen.
Give me the gun, please. We're gonna get him, just not like this.
Why not? That's how we did Alice Markham.
Kayla, he's not worth your life. You do this, and that's what you're throwing away. Now give it to me.
No.
Frank, let's do something.
He has to pay.
Well, we'll get him. Now, Kayla, give me the gun. Now. It's okay. It's okay.
Sorry.
And I'm gonna get rid of this, and then I'm going down to my car to get that bottle of scotch I have. Do you want to join me?
No, you go on. We're not finished.
Now, I'm gonna be right back. Don't do anything crazy.
Oh, well. I promise.
Convincing.
It's all right, I'll talk to him.
Mr. Markham, I already told you I can't testify.
You did. That's what you told me. Now I want you to tell Ann. Come on, girl, it's all right. This is Lisa, and this is Maureen, our... my children. Girls, this is Duncan MacLeod.
Markham, don't do this.
Lisa's starting softball this year. Maureen has to get braces. Alice promised her a kitten. Now you tell them why you won't testify. You tell them why you won't help find a man who murdered their mother. Go ahead, MacLeod, they're waiting.
I'm sorry.
Look, I know you were there. I know it. Is it money? Is that it?
No, it's not like that.
Look, here's $200,000. $200,000 just for telling the truth.
It's not about the money.
Well, then what will it take, damn it? It's all I have. Here, take it.
I can't. I'm so sorry.
Come on, girls, let's go.
$200,000, Mac, in my hand, just for telling the truth. You know what I could do with that kind of money?
You didn't take it.
Of course not, but I can't say I wasn't tempted. It would have changed my life.
Yeah, I've gotten you killed.
It's not about the money, Mac. It's about Markham. It's about his kids. The guy's tearing himself apart.
Don't you think I know that?
Then why in the hell can't we just help him?
Because Kimman is mine.
I don't get you, Mac. Sometimes you are unbelievable. You're the first one to talk about justice. The first one to talk about what's right.
That's what this is about, justice.
Damn it, for what? For a guy who died over 2 centuries ago?
Time doesn't make any difference, Richie.
What about Markham? What about his little girls?
Kimman will get what's coming to him.
Mac, you kill Kidman, you get satisfaction.
Hey, it's not about my satisfaction.
Yeah, right.
He's done this for centuries.
Bull, Mac. You kill him, they'll never know about it. They'll spend the rest of their lives thinking he got away.
And that we let him. I know.
And we just go ahead and live with that.
What do you want?
Why did Kimman come after you?
You don't want to come forward, fine. Just leave.
Come on, answer the question.
I don't know.
Really?
Look at me, Mr. MacLeod. What do you see? Nothing. Because that's what I am, nothing.
That's not what I see. I see a man so hurt he doesn't know what he's doing. A man so angry he uses children's grief as a weapon. You want to tell me why?
My wife is dead. The killer goes free. That's not reason enough.
There's more to it than that. Why did she die? What did you do?
It should have been me. I deserved it. It was my fault.
Why?
I'm not a rich man, Mr. MacLeod. Just a little bit successful. But I had to buy that success. I took a loan from a man I had no business knowing. Vince Petrovic.
And when you try to pay him back?
He wanted half the store. Said he was my partner. I told him to go to hell.
You didn't think he'd come after you?
I thought I could handle it. I thought I was tough enough. I never thought... Alice never even knew about the loan.
And you didn't tell the police?
If I did, he'd come after my kids. To lose someone like that, to have it happen because of you, you can't understand what that feels like.
Maybe I can.
I don't know why you decided to come forward, Mr. MacLeod, but I'm glad you did. Just take your time. Can't see you. Won't even know you're standing here.
Sure he won't. That's the man that killed Alice Moore.
All it was very dark, and you will be under oath.
That's him.
done. Except for one thing.
What's that?
Well, Markham's taking a second mortgage out on his house, and he's borrowing everything he can on his store.
So?
Well, some people are saying he paid you to testify.
He didn't.
If that came out in court, your testimony would be inadmissible, and Kinman walks.
He didn't pay me.
That's all you have to say?
That's all there is.
We'll be in touch.
That's a lot of money to be carrying around. I heard this neighborhood isn't safe after dark.
That depends who you are. Do I know you?
No. I'm Duncan MacLeod.
What can I do for you, Duncan MacLeod?
Just stay away from David Markham.
Who?
The man you hired Paul Kinman to kill.
It's okay, Joey. Listen to the mouth on this guy. Now, is it slander or is it libel? I forget which. But either one. Accusations like that can get a person in a lot of trouble.
Paul Kimmon's gone away for life. Don't send anyone else.
If this fantasy you've concocted were true, and I could order a person's death over the telephone, why wouldn't I order yours?
Because you're a businessman. And you deal in what you know. And you don't know me, and that worries you a little.
Hey, Joey. Do I look worried? You got nerve, I'll give you that. I think I've heard enough of this clown.
Stay away from David Markham. It's good business. Hey, Joey. You know what? I could have been a contender.
What is it?
I left the transfer sheets up in the office. You want to go get them?
No, forget it. They'll fax them over later.
You know what a pain in the ass they can be at county. Why don't you just go get the papers, Frank?
Leave you alone down here with this?
I can handle him. They're going to be pissed, you know.
So let them be pissed. Let's go. Was that supposed to be police brutality? Just keep it moving, scuzzball.
You know, I don't mind the chains so much, but I do hate walking like this. No dignity.
Yeah, so write a book in prison.
Not part of my plans, I'm afraid.
Can't write?
Actually, I write rather well, Frank. I'm just not going to prison.
That's what they all say.
I know. But they're not all screwing your partner. Or are they, Kayla, darling? Jesus.
Kayla.
Why didn't you go for the damn papers, Frank?
Don't
shoot him.
Escaped from jail.
When?
Last night. They were moving him. He killed an FBI guy and disappeared. How do we stop a guy like that?
We don't.
I take it you're planning to kill him.
It's been a long time coming.
I thought you said he was good, Mac. Really good. Maybe even better than you.
I don't care.
You want him that bad, huh?
I let him get away once. I'm not going to do it again. Close the house up for me, Rich.
Sure.
Maybe it wasn't smart killing Frank like that.
We just have to think this thing through.
I'm sure you're right.
I got it. Okay, you rough me up. Make it look good, okay? Then you put the cuffs on me. I stagger back to the last gas station.
I kidnapped you. Is that the story?
Sure. You got my gun away. You killed Frank. You made me drive you out here, and then you dumped me out of the car. Then, a few months later, post-traumatic stress, I resigned from the bureau and meet you at the villa.
Maybe you're right. Maybe I did get your gun away.
Paul, what are you doing?
Making you more convincing. The villa won't be the same without you, my love.
Escaped. I think you should take your little girls and get out of town for a couple of days.
Paper or plastic?
Look, you've got a cabin in the country. You can spend some time with your little girls. It's safe.
Don't worry about me and MacLeod. I want to see Petrovic.
You caved? You gave him a piece of your business?
You bet your ass I did. I go to sleep scared and I wake up scared. What if he sends someone else after me? What if my little girls get in the way? It's over. He wins.
You think it's over? It's never over. You give him half your business now, in 6 months he'll have all of it. If you refuse, you'll be looking over your shoulder for the rest of your life, wondering where the next bullet is coming from.
What else can I do?
I don't know. I don't know.
Greetings.
Kinman. I heard you were out.
I've come for my money.
What money? You missed. You got caught. And I was told you were a pro.
Maybe you don't understand. You see, I've got the police and the FBI looking for me, so I need my money, and I need to get out of the country.
That's your problem.
True, but now I'm making it your problem. So let's have a little cooperation, shall we?
You'll die for this.
Does that mean you're not going to help me?
Nobody threatens me. You don't know it, Kidman, but you're already a dead man.
Why is it that men with power always feel that they're invulnerable?
My leg!
You know, there was a time when a man like me had the ear of royalty.
Believe it! You shot me!
And a single man's death could change the course of a war.
I bleed like a stuck
or the fate of a nation.
You're a freaking wacko! Crazy bastard.
Now the barons are paltry merchants and moneylenders.
Okay, look. You need some money, I'll help you.
And the elegant weapons of yesterday have been reduced to this machine.
I'll get you out of the country, no problem.
Where's the challenge in that?
You want to challenge Kimmon? Here I am.
Grown a backbone, have we? Sabres at dawn?
This will do. Right now. What's the matter? Don't you trust your sword arm?
Of course, my dear fellow. But these things are such fun. Stuck pig. Friend of yours?
Friend of yours? Can't you beat me with that, you little toy?
Of course.
I'm still Paul King. First blood.
I told you. I never fight for sport.
I don't fight for sport either.
Yes.
England.
Hello, Mr. Markham.
Life goes on, huh? I got a business to run.
At least you don't have to share it with a partner. Petrovic's out of the meat business.
Yeah, I heard. It's all over the street. I don't know why he did it, but thank you.
Well, it wasn't me.
Then who?
Kimman.
I don't believe it. The man's not human. I mean, he keeps on killing and keeps getting away with it. Now he's gonna get away with this one, too.
How are your kids making out?
Well, my sister flew in from San Francisco. She's gonna be staying with us for a while.
Well, that's good. Look, I've gotta be going. I just wanted to stop by and see how you were doing.
One day at a time. Thanks for all you're trying to do. I just wish there'd been some justice for Alice. I'm sorry, I better get back to work.
Mr. Markham. Kidman didn't get away with it.